Hello everybody, Dick Hyde here. Just a quick little intro to number one, apologize for the audio and the rest of the video. I forgot to check the settings before I started recording. I didn't notice it until I went to go edit everything. But today's project, clearing out a fig tree stump. Pretty big fig tree, about 15 feet wide, 12 feet tall. Basically covered all the way from the fence, over to the bedroom window, and up to the peak. It died over the winter time, and it had to go. It was just a big skeleton of a tree. Came out earlier in the week, cut it back with a chainsaw, left myself a little bit of a stump, knowing that I'd be able to come out and dig it up with a skid steer. Now, when I first started it, I was anticipating being able to pluck it out with the with my little fence post puller. Wasn't sure how that was going to go. My backup plan, I do have a stump bucket that I was prepared to use, but as you'll see, it works out pretty well with the fence post puller. Enjoy the video. if I can get you a little better angle on what's going on here. I couldn't tell if you could see very well from the other angle, but it does appear to be working, so I just gotta wiggle it out a little bit. We'll plug it out and see how big the root ball is. that went a lot better than what I was expecting. Let's take a look here, see what we got. So I was half right on the, I guess, the girth of the root ball. I was expecting to be at least as wide as what the tree was. I did not expect how shallow the roots were and how, what's the opposite of dense? Yeah, obviously not me. But how spread out the roots were. A couple main shoots, plucked them right out, and everything seemed to work pretty well. So hopefully it looked as cool on camera as it did from the operator's seat. Good thing the wife is playing softball this weekend, because I got to clean the rest of this up and make it look pretty before she gets back on Sunday. But that's that. I guess I'll take a moment to show you the attachment up close. So here it is. Don't know the name brand on it. I got it at an auction out of Mount Olive, North Carolina. When I got it, one side of the grippers there was bent, the movable side. Some of the welds on the fixed side for reinforcement were broken. Took it to a local weld shop, I think $150, $175 bucks. They straightened it, welded it, and got it back in operation. The only other thing that I've done to it is I had to get new couplers, because when I bought it, there were no couplers on it. And then the pins down here were missing the clevis pins, or the hairpins, whatever you want to call them. The only thing I don't like about my setup here is 9 times out of 10, I've got to shut the machine off and then manually cycle the hydraulics in order to get the QDs hooked up. My understanding is that's a fairly common deal for older skid steers. Not terribly annoying, but just enough so that, you know, if you're in a rush trying to get implements swapped back and forth, it can be a little frustrating, especially since I do normally try to let the machine idle for a minute before I shut it off, just to, you know, save wear and tear on the engine and everything. But yeah, that's pretty much it. The skid steer itself, I bought it at auction from Greenville, South Carolina, which is, what, 20, 30 minutes from my mom's house. I don't recommend my approach. I won the auction, got notified of it, and then had to explain to the wife why I got to go to Greenville on a Sunday to pick this up on a Monday. She's quite understanding. She's actually been very supportive. We've recently started trying to flip properties. We are currently on our second property, and this thing is proven invaluable. What I estimate would cost me probably at least $1,000 for someone else to do. I load up, I go out, play for 2-3 hours, and the property is in a sellable condition. That'll be a separate video. I do have most everything cleared off that I wanted to clear off. I do have one large trash pile down there I gotta get rid of. And like I said, that'll be a separate video sometime in the near future. We're expecting some heavy thunderstorms, and that property, the access to it is a shared private dirt road, and the least little bit of rain, it just puddles up and looks like crap, and trying to get a 32-foot gooseneck trailer down there is not fun. But this will wrap up today's video. Again, I was pleasantly surprised with how easy that came out. I was a little nervous at first when I tried to grab it and the gripper wasn't wide enough. But as you saw, different angle, different approach, grabbed it, worked it free, and then just peeled everything out.